Because I want to know, what is the view of this story from the other side? Has this been picked up by Pakistani media, news channels? I mean, it's intriguing to see that Pakistan has become a talking point in a domestic election here in India. And like I said, it's not the first time. And Vinod Sharma is right. There used to be a time back in the 90s when India was a talking point in Pakistani elections, but I'm not sure that that's the case anymore. I mean, the MQM, for example, used to be referred to as the pro-India party and so on and so forth, but not the case anymore.
Right, that's right, Zaka. Thank you for having on board the Pakistani perspective, firstly. And I'd like to make a very humble disclaimer here before I go on with my note here. I'm neither defending Congress nor defending BJP in the debate. I'm here to defend Pakistan's perspective. Our Foreign Office spokesperson, Dr. Mohammed Faisal, has made it very clear that, as you've mentioned yourself, this isn't the first time that Prime Minister Modi has made a mention in his speeches of Pakistan and has made it a matter, a subject matter to his content. This had happened last year or last to last year, if I recall correctly, on the 15th of August when he was addressing a rally, and he called out to the people of Balochistan. So, you see, that isn't the first of an instance that has happened in this case. Particularly when you're talking about the Gujarat polls and the UP polls, we'd like to see the governance criteria being fulfilled. And, of course, may the best man, may the best party win for the Indian public. But I don't know who's making that sermon note here. I'm not offensive to any one of you folks. Please mind that. But please let me complete my point here. The Gujarat polls have to be mandated by the criteria of governance that was brought up by Mr. Narendra Modi himself. He's been talking about the Vikas system. He's been talking about the governance criteria, which depend on development, employment, and so much more. Literacy rate and whatnot, the inflation rate, the price rise.
Okay, GVL, I think, wants to respond.
He better be talking about these points and how must he fulfill these criteria rather than referring to Pakistan.
GVL wants to respond.
It is irresponsible, to say the least.
No, please
respond. I'd like to hear from you.
Yes. I only hope you had the same freedom to talk about governance in your country, a country which has been ravaged by terrorists, a country which has nothing but terrorism to export.
Like Zaka has said, we've never made a mention of India that way in our speeches, as a matter of fact.
We don't need to be sermonized. Please stay off. I think your foreign spokesperson was completely out of his brief. He had no business to comment. Anyway, that's my political comment. As far as this issue is concerned, Zaka, this is not the first time. This is not the first time.
You mean your Prime Minister has all the prerogative to comment on Pakistan, but our Foreign Minister, but our Foreign Office has no point to even respond?
Okay, let him.
No,
GVL, it's a simple question. Now, are we getting to a state, and I think this is what Ajay also asked, do private citizens...